My name is Maria Keller and I'm a digital artist from Mexico. On this tutorial, I'll teach you how to make a world more interesting through the use of depth. All the keys and shortcuts I use will be displayed on the screen so you can follow along. Let's begin. The first thing we're gonna do is open Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. If you don't know how to do that, I'm gonna teach you very quickly how. So you're gonna go here to File and go here on New, or you can press Ctrl N on your keyboard. And once you do that, a window like this should appear. I'm using the latest version of Illustrator CC, so if your interface looks different, it's totally fine, because this information, while in a different layout, it should be the same. So you're gonna select here and type a width of 600 and a height of 800. You're gonna make sure that your orientation, sorry, it's horizontal, so it's actually inverting the numbers. And then you're gonna go here on color mode, and make sure that you're selecting RGB, because you're not going to be printing this project, and then you hit create. Once you have your document open, the first thing we're going to do is create a world that will be the one that will contain our different layers of depth. So I'm going to go here to my tools panel, or press T on my keyboard, and when I go do that, I'm just going to simply click and type, in the case of myself, I want to do hello. So I have my world there. Now, if you are not sure what kind of font you want to use, or if you want to type a different word, like for example you want to type your name, you probably want to pick a font that reflects a little bit your personality or the word that you are typing. So a great site to find very nice fonts is Google Fonts. And what Google Fonts does is that this site that I just opened right here, it lets you select the different fonts that you want. So for example, if you want a font that has serif or doesn't have serif, or if you want a handwriting mode because probably you're typing your name or something that is more fun. And here you can see that I click on the thickness and then I took it all the way, or probably a little bit more to the top, because I want a font that is bold enough so I can see the inside of it and see the layers that I'm going to place inside. So in my case, I went for Allegre Sans, and you can also type in here a little preview and see how your word would look. So you can type in hello, or you can type in here hola, which means hello in Spanish. And now that you have selected your font, you can type your word in here in Illustrator, and then the next thing you want to do is to center it on my canvas. So to do that, you can see that when you select an object, here at the top, you can see the alignment tools, or you can go here window, align, or press shift F7. Once you do that, a window like this should appear, and here you can align your objects, and in here on the bottom you can see align to, and if you click there you can see that you can align to the selection or align to the artboard. In our case we want to align to the artboard, so I'm going to click here and that's okay, and then I'm going to go here on the top where it says align objects and align to horizontal align center, and then to vertical align center. And now I have my word right in the center. Now the next thing I want to do is select my word, or clicking on it, and then go right click, and then go create outlines, or press Ctrl Shift O. Once you do that, now you're going to have paths instead of the text that you had before. And the next thing you're going to do is select your word, or your text, or your X text, because now it's paths, and here, go and swap the fill and the stroke, so you can only see the outline. And now I'm going to lock this layer, and here I have the layers window, but if you don't see it for whatever reason, you can go here to window and find layers, or press F7. And here I'm going to lock it by clicking right next to the eyeball, so I no longer can select my word by accident and move it. And I'm going to go here on the bottom and create a new layer, and place this layer beneath the layer that contains my word. Now I'm going to use the pencil tool, and if you go here in your tools panel, probably by default you're going to see this tool that is called the shaper tool, but if you click and hold that click, you're going to find the pencil tool, or you can press N on your keyboard. Once you do that, you are going to be able to put your cursor and draw with it. So what I'm going to do right now is just click here and make a line, and you can see how I make a curve. Now if your hand is a little shaky, or you are using a mouse, as I am doing right now, you can go double click here on the pencil tool and the option will appear. Now in here you can see that the fidelity can you can move this around to make it more accurate so everything that you do will be exactly as you do, or you can take it here to smooth so it will smooth the path, and even when your hand is shaking, the path will be kind of smooth. So I took it here right on the middle and I'm gonna hit OK, and I'm gonna keep making these shapes, or this line, sorry, like this, and then make another line here, and then make another one here. And you can always undo by pressing Ctrl C if you don't like what you did. So I'm gonna do something like this, and then finally something like that. So now that I have this, I want to close these lines so they are paths. So I'm gonna go here to my pen tool or press P on my keyboard, and then click here, and then click around here so I make sure that my shape, when it closes, it covers all the world. And then I'm gonna click here and do the same for the other lines. And now that you are finished with this, the next thing would be to add color. I had already selected my palette to save time, but you can feel free to pick colors that work for your world and reflect the personality or the text that you are typing. So I'm going to select this first path that I created and swap the fill and the color, sorry, fill and stroke, because I don't need a stroke, and then select this green, and then I'm going to select that same color for this other shape. And then I'm going to select this other color for this part of the hello. And then select another color like this for this other part of the hello. And what I want to do is select this one and send it to back, so it's actually behind this other color. And I actually want to bring this green to the front. So I'm going to select the green and go right click, arrange, bring to front. Or you can press Ctrl Shift, close bracket. And then I'm going to select this blue, sorry, and go right click, arrange, send to back. And then for this other shape, I'm going to select this other green. And now you can go here on your tools panel and select the rectangle tool or press M. And what I'm going to do is create a rectangle that is big enough to cover all the world. I'm going to fill it with this blue color, and I'm going to send it to back again by going arrange, send to back, or Ctrl Shift open bracket. And just as before, you can just as always, when you are selecting shapes, you can move them around until you think you are happy with your result. So for example, I think that's okay. And now I'm going to actually add depth to this. So I'm going to select everything and then shift and click on the rectangle so I don't select that one. And then I'm going to add a little bit of depth by going here to Effect, Stylize, Drop Shadow. And if you do that, a window like this will appear, and you can click here on the preview so you can see a preview of what you want. And I had already selected my parameters of what I want, so I actually want an opacity that is 75%, a mode that is in multiply, and actually, instead of having a color that is black for my shadow, I want to click here on darkness and have it 100%, and then the rest of the values, offset it in X 1.5, and offset it in Y 1.5, and the opacity as I had it, and I'm going to click OK. So now you can really see which shape is on top of the other. And now what I want to do is make a mask. So I'm going to unlock my layer that contains my text. And what you can do is, if you have a shape that is on the top of the others, you could make a mask. But if you select your text, if you go here on the appearance, and if you don't have the window, you can go here window appearance or press shift F6. And if you see, when I select my text, you can see that this is a group. It's not actually a path. And what this means is that if I double click on this world, you can see that each individual letter is actually a compound path, but they are all contained in a group, so I don't want that. I'm going to select my text and go Object, Compound Path, Make, or press Ctrl 8. And when I do that, now you can see that it's actually removed the fill and stroke, but I can click here and make it black all again. But you can see on the appearance how now it's a compound path. So now if I make the mask, it would work. So I'm going to select everything and then go right click, make clipping mask. And when I do that, my world now has contained the layers that I created on the other one. And you can still change this. So if you double click on this, you can go inside that clip group that now is on the clipping mask and move around your shape. So for example, maybe you can move this around here, make this green a little bit more prominent, and move this one a little bit to the top. So you can see all these little details that now are appearing here, and then double click outside this. And now with this, you have given more depth to a world and make it more interesting instead of that boring. And again, just as before, you can double click and move around your shapes until you are happy with the result. So with this, we have concluded this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.